To Gimme a Break, the show where the kids call the shots on the family holiday. For them, it's a dream come true, but for the parents, it's a nightmare.
On Gimme a Break, the kids have all the say. They decide where they go, what activities they do, and most importantly, they're in charge of the holiday rules.
So, which family are about to be whisked away? Let's find out.
Meet the Marshall family. Truck driver Dad. Teacher Mum. 11-year-old drummer Jack. Football mad Tom, who's 9. And let's not forget, guinea pigs Stig and Simon. So why do Jack and Tom deserve to be given a break?
We mainly stay in the UK for our holidays. We hardly ever go abroad. We once went to this attraction where there was loads of gnomes. We even had to dress up as gnomes.
We really loved it.
I felt like an idiot.
I don't think the boys really enjoyed that bit very much.
I felt really stupid.
Mum's training to be a teacher in university. She tries to teach us loads of things, especially on holiday.
If there's 4 of us and the tickets are so much, how much would the total be?
She's like, what's 9 times 25? I'm like, I don't know.
You know, there's a learning opportunity around every corner.
Oh, come on. I'm like, I don't know.
Me and Tom, we really love fast things and fast rides. But Mum and Dad hate fast rides and fast things.
I like to go on the rides that are totally safe.
He doesn't want to go on because he's really a wuss.
Once we all went quad biking as a family, it felt really, really fast. But apparently I was going about 1 or 2 miles an hour because all the small children were passing me.
Every time Dad sits down for more than 10 minutes, he always falls asleep.
And there's always on holidays.
I tend to fall asleep quite regularly. 10 minutes, I'll be fast asleep.
Once we take over the holiday, there'll be no disasters.
Lads, having heard your list of complaints, is it time to turn the tables?
Yes!
Mum and Dad, are you ready to hand over control of the family break?
If we have to.
Yeah.
Well, it's happening right here, right now. It's the Gimme a Break parent promise. Hands on hearts, please.
We the parents of Jack and Tom, hereby hand over control of the next family break.
Unhappy?
Yeah.
Happy?
Yes! Now it's time for us to teach you a lesson about holidays.
Now get to your room!
Wowzers. Yeah, off you go. Good work, fellas. Goodness me. Actually, we should get down to business now. Come on, this way.
Jack, Tom, you are now in total control. What's the best thing about that?
You get to boss Mum and Dad about. Do whatever you like. Brilliant.
You seem very happy about it. You happy too?
Yeah.
So what sort of things would you like from your holiday?
Snow. Definitely snow.
Okay, snow.
Fast, exciting, once-in-a-lifetime opportunities.
Okay, that's enough for me to be working with. I'll see what I can come up with.
Now I know what the boys are after, I've found 3 brilliant breaks for them to choose from. But before I reveal the holidays, they'll have to do some guesswork. First up, clue number 1.
I reckon, because that snow, it's probably somewhere snowy. So it might be somewhere cold and snowy.
Yeah, snow, snow.
Snow, keep that in your head.
So just to clarify, you're thinking snow, yeah?
Clue! Go through this clue to guess what you might do.
Whoa! I found some things! Germany flags!
So that's definitely German, yeah. Somewhere snowy.
Sausages!
Sausages!
These are German sausages.
Yeah. What does Eason C. Mitch mean?
Tasty big sausages, maybe?
Not quite, Jack.
Salami.
Is that
it
heavy?
It says, inch costly gut.
That might be pig's gut.
Yeah. Oh dear, doesn't get any better.
Guts. I think it might be making sausages in the snow. Yeah, I like that.
Let's see if the boys can do better on break number 2.
What's this? Cool.
moustache.
It's a French hat with a moustache.
Bonjour.
Oh, there it is.
Ah, cool.
You'll need a pair of these. The arranged letters made of cheese.
Isk, no, disk. Six. Skis.
Skis and moustaches and hats.
So, skiing in either Italy or France.
Follow the paw prints for break number three. Welcome to the Gimme a Break Puppet Show.
I love puppet shows.
Mom, Dad, go faster, go faster.
And it was funny when me and Jack said, go, hurry up, and he just slowed down.
Slow it down, Lizzie.
Husky.
So it might be husky riding.
What country do huskies and reindeer come from?
North Pole, Greenland, the South Pole. It would be extremely fun to go husky riding.
Ah, bonus bears!
The end.
You look like you were having a great time trying to work out those holiday clues, were you?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Actually, I think I know what number one is already.
Do you indeed, Jack? Well, let's go for it then. What do you reckon?
I think it's making sausages in Germany.
It is Germany.
Yay.
Yeah. It's a snowboarding trip to Germany.
Oh, I'm doing this.
Have a look.
You'll be whizzing down the snow-capped mountains of Bavaria in Germany, trying out snowboarding and snow tubing.
What do you make of that?
Look cool. Brilliant.
What about snowboarding lessons? Do you like the sound of that, Tom?
Yeah, it's really fast and not really, really fast, just fast.
Let me show you break two then. First of all, any notion of where it was?
It might be skiing in the French Alps.
You're absolutely right. It is a ski break in the French Alps.
Yeah. There'll be no boring maths classes on the slopes of Mont Blanc. Instead, you'll be having skiing lessons. After a day on the mountains, you'll be relaxing in a hot tub.
What do you think?
It'll be quite hard because I'm not very balanced. I can't balance very well.
So that worries you slightly?
Yeah.
Well, of course, you've got three choices. So break number three, what do you think that is?
I think it's going husky riding in Antarctica.
Break number three is actually an Arctic adventure in Finland.
Cool.
Cool.
If you choose this break, Mum and Dad will need to hold on tight, as you'll be pulled on a sled by a team of huskies. And you'll have the chance to feed polar bears in a sanctuary.
Is there anything in that break that really appeals to you?
Meeting the husky dogs and going husky riding. That'd be, yeah. And seeing the actual polar bears, because I've never seen a live polar bear before.
Have you got a front runner in your mind then?
Actually, no, they're all too good, so can you just leave us alone for a minute to decide?
I absolutely can, yes. Mull all three over, what you like, maybe what you don't like, and I'll come back when you've got a decision.
Three choices.
Yeah.
Number one.
I would love to go snowboarding.
Number two.
Do you like to go skiing?
Yeah, it's okay.
So, number one, maybe.
Yeah.
Number two. No. Right, number three.
Yeah.
You get to see lots of animals. It's between number one, number three.
Right, have you two made your minds up?
Yes. The break number that we have chosen is number...
Can we do a drum roll here?
Three!
Finland! Why Finland?
Because we love animals.
Excellent, we'll have a trip of a lifetime. Just remember to pack their thermals, won't you, whilst you're over there? I'll pop up on the laptop during your trip, see how you're getting on, and I will set you a final challenge to win one last amazing treat. But I've got to warn you, if you muck it up, I'm going to have to give the treat to Mum and Dad.
Oh, no. Oh, we're not going to do that.
Enjoy it, won't you? Have a smashing time.
Okay. Yes.
So the Marshalls are jetting off to Finland for an Arctic adventure. But will Mum and Dad freeze up with all that high-speed action? And who will win that final treat?
Come on, please make it right.
With less than 24 hours before the trip, it's time to pack for everyone. So the boys are busy in Mum and Dad's bedroom.
Very sensible. I think that they'd pack appropriate stuff, really. Maybe not very neatly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, but my dad wear that.
Quite, I'll chuck some in and have a good laugh about that.
I won't be able to find it because it's all white.
Other bad things you could pack for me would be anything to do with work.
That's my dad wear his lovely uniform.
Green shirt, green trousers.
And the green goblet.
The worst thing they could pack would be one of my, like, really nice designer high-heeled pair of shoes.
Big mum's high heels.
Oh, yeah.
I don't really go out in them very much. I keep them for special occasions.
Yeah!
The marshals have arrived at Heathrow Airport. Mum and Dad have no idea where they're going, but a mysterious-looking traveller is about to reveal all.
Wow, look at that! Look at the edge of the
Wow! Wow! Look at that!
Look at that!
Art adventure!
Oh, just so excited, it'd be fantastic!
Are you clever?
Yeah.
I really, really didn't think we were going out in the country.
I think the Mum and Dad will really love this holiday because it's so, so different.
You can't tell us what we're going to be doing.
No.
I'm really apprehensive about what activities will be required to do when we're over there, but it's all part of the excitement, isn't it?
Jake, I'm so excited.
That's magic.
Have a lovely flight.
Thank you. The marshals are excited to be up in the air and making use of the Gimme a Break fan cam.
This is key for sleep on the plane.
Enjoy it while you can, Dad. After a 7-hour journey, the Marshall family have finally arrived in Rovaniemi on the Arctic Circle. The temperature is -5, so Mum and Dad are keen to find out if the boys have packed what they need.
Oh, it's all squished
in.
A T-shirt in the Arctic.
My green work gear, which I don't need. The yellow shorts. I can't wear the yellow shorts, can I?
Why are you laughing?
Oh, my pyjamas, thank you.
Boys have packed a few good things, I have to say. They have packed me a couple of scarves. They've packed me a few jumpers.
How am I going to go in the snow with these?
It's just the tip of the iceberg. It's all downhill from now on. I've got no control whatsoever.
And you haven't even heard the rules yet, Mum.
Uber pie, the Marshall family. That's good day in Finnish. Now, before your adventure can begin, the boys have some rules for you. The boys are tired of being taught on holiday, Mum. So rule number one is no educational tests or questions.
This is such a fantastic place. There's so much to learn here.
Rule number two is for you, Dad.
Oh, no.
Jack and Tom are fed up with you falling asleep all the time, so there'll be no nodding off on this trip.
Could quite happily nod off right now in the sunshine.
You got to try harder than anything, Dad.
Finally, this rule applies to both Mum and Dad. The boys are tired of the slow rides and taking it easy on holiday. They want action and adventure. That's why rule number three is that the boys will set the speed whatever activity you're doing.
Oh, no. I can't do fast things.
Neither.
Well, bad luck, because they are.
I'll try my best to go as fast as I can. Oh, am I allowed to scream if I go really fast?
No.
I must warn you, though, if these rules are broken, there will be consequences, just like school, Mum. Have fun, family. I'll be popping up later to tell you all about your special treat. Bye.
Bye, Kirsten.
Bye.
It's just in my nature to teach them everything. I can't help it, and it's going to be really hard.
I think it'll be quite hard. To be honest, I do nod off quite regularly.
I dread to think what they'll get me to do, something fast and an adrenaline sort of rush, which, although it'll be fun, oh, it'll be a nightmare too.
Well, Mum, your nightmares are about to come true, as the boys want to kick-start this break with some high-speed action.
Right, Mum and Dad, today we're taking you down a 150-metre tobogganing wall.
And to keep track on your time, we'll bring this stopwatch to see who is the fastest and the slowest.
Oh, no!
You got to go all the way down there?
Yes. When I told Mum and Dad that they were going tobogganing, they really weren't very happy at all.
Oh, it's going to be so fast. They do have really good brakes, yeah? OK, then. I would never normally do this sort of 150-metre toboggan run on holiday. The most I'd probably do is a slight helter-skelter.
Looks like Dad's been picked to go first.
Three, two, One, go.
Oh, and he's off.
Oh. Oh, no, he's not.
That felt really frightening. My heart's going really fast.
I can beat it.
You've got to beat your dad.
Go!
Go on, yeah.
It was extremely, extremely scary, but that's because I didn't put the brake on.
Hell yeah. That was good.
Ready and stop it.
You did very well.
I think I've got about 20 seconds.
Go on, Tom!
Go on, Tom!
Go on, Tom!
Go on, Tom!
Go on, Tom! Woo! Go on, Tom!
Wow! Go on, Tom!
Well done, Tom!
He's beating Dad.
Oh, he's not quick.
I think I went really fast, and I think I got a better time than Dad, because he didn't have a very good start.
With Mum being left till last, she's even more nervous.
No, I don't want to go.
The slope looks really, really steep, and the toboggans look really small.
Go!
Go in.
Looks
like he's plowing the field.
Put your palms together now.
My heart is racing so much. I'm just shaking like a leaf. It was so scary.
The results of the toboggan race are happily in first place with 20 seconds. It's me. In a close second. With 21 seconds, it's Tom.
Ah! Well done, Tom.
And then third place, with 35 seconds, is Dad.
Oh!
And last place is Mum with 45 seconds.
Yay! Woo! Look, it was that fast.
It may be the end of the day, but it's not the end of high-speed action.
Tonight, Mum and Dad, you are going to be going snowmobiling whilst you're tugging us on sleigh across there.
Really?
Yes.
And you need these to wear to pull us and to make you look like reindeers.
Oh, wow.
Dad,
you're going to drive the snowmobile.
Wow.
You are a truck driver and you know what you're doing. You will put the brake on all the time, won't you?
Yes, I will.
So that's why we didn't pick you.
If I'm not driving, I don't have to wear these then.
Yes, you do.
Yes, you do.
Sitting behind that. And we're going to take you out to tea tonight, but this is a surprise where we're going.
Don't drive like a granny, Dad. Remember, the boys want speed.
Ah, put the pedal to the metal. That's not like it, man.
Oh, this is really good. It was very fast and it was a bit scary.
I don't think that he went fast enough.
Well, I think we were going fast enough for the boys. Because some of it was a bit bumpy.
Oh, I'm just speechless. Even though I'm talking,
all I can see around here is trees and snow, so they must be taking us on somewhere else to a really nice restaurant, I think.
Think again, Mum.
Wow, boys, this wasn't quite the fancy restaurant I thought you'd take me to tonight, but, you know, I don't care. This is fantastic. The night sky is amazing.
I think you're as fast as you've done now, Tom.
That's hot.
Yeah. Boys, you made the right decision there, letting Dad drive. There's no way I would have gone fast and that looked well scary.
As the sun shines on Ravani Emmy, the family are heading out of town.
So you book a
Dad'll need to wake up as the boys have a huge surprise.
You know that polar bear at the airport?
Yeah.
Well, today you're going to see the real thing.
Really?
Yeah, yes. A real polar bear.
Yes, and you're going to feed it.
No.
Oh, my word.
No, not.
Yes. Oh, that's amazing. Yes.
To show the marshals round the polar bear sanctuary, who better than animal expert Lionel?
Oh, my.
The male is quite sleepy today. Sleeping a lot. Just like daddy.
Oh, my word.
The big one down there, the male, weighs something like 700 or 800 kilos. The female, half of the weight. You want to throw some apples to the polar bear?
Yeah.
Over here. Throw it as far as you can. Just through there.
Tom, that's fantastic. How big are their paws? They look really big.
Minimum 35 centimeters.
That's 35. Just big as a ruler.
So that's the size of the male.
Wow, I've fed a polar bear a carrot.
The most I've ever fed is our guinea pigs, and I've never fed anything more than that, a polar bear. Wow, what an experience.
I just can't believe that I saw a polar bear with my very own eyes. It's brilliant.
His paws were massive.
Dad's hoping the boys have forgotten that he nodded off earlier, but no such luck.
Dad, because you fell asleep, this means that you broke a rule.
Yeah.
And this means that you've got to wear these.
Put those on and walk down there near those people.
Amen.
People were just looking at him and laughing, and his little bandy legs sticking out. It was so funny.
The marshals are about to go on a husky ride, something they've always dreamt of doing.
This really is the reason why we wanted to come to Finland.
I like dogs a lot, and this is something that I've always wanted to do. We would never have chosen something like this. The boys, they're amazing. I think they're fab.
I'm really excited because I really love dogs.
But there's a surprise in store for Mum and Dad.
Or left or anything. You will have your own team.
Don't have to try that ourselves.
Yes, you do.
Oh, no.
When we got here, I was all right because I thought, oh, that'd be nice sitting on a sledge, going along, taking it easy. But now I know that I'm in control. That's a bit scary.
If it goes to the left side, you go to the left. If it goes to the right, you go to the right.
Okay.
There is only one small little problem with the dogs. Only one little small problem. They don't want to stop. And you can yell whatever you want, in which language you want. They won't stop. That's why we have the brake over here.
We've got all these dogs that want to run and run and run. And controlling an animal is not the same as controlling a machine.
I don't really want to disappoint the boys by going really slowly, so I'm going to try and be really, really brave and keep my foot off the brake.
I'm so excited!
The dogs are ready to go and the rope's really tight.
I'm a little bit frightened, but you know, I'm never going to do this again. Let's go for it!
It shut off and the power, and we're going, and we're going. Thanks, Jack. How cool is this?
I was quite scared, but then when we get going, oh wow, I just fly past. It's fantastic.
Tom, look at to your left.
This is that frozen lake.
What a frozen lake on a husky sled.
I'm reborn into a speed demon.
Right, we're going for the left turn.
Wow, now we're going through the trees. She's loving it, Mummy.
Tom, this is the best thing we've ever done. Is it you?
Yeah.
I'm so proud of Mum and Dad. Controlling all them husky dogs, I wouldn't think they would be able to do that.
You were so slow. You're like slow lane trucker man. And we were like, come on, hurry up.
boys have completely turned me to life in the fast lane. I love it.
Out of all of the things I've done in my life, this is the best. Top of the list. Brilliant. Absolutely amazing.
Fantastic choice. The things that we've been doing, it's once in a lifetime. It's like a dream come true. It's amazing.
Before the marshals leave the snow behind, there's one final treat to be won. It's a rare opportunity to go go-karting on a frozen river, so there's all to play for. But who will be racing on ice? Mum and Dad or Jack and Tom?
Hi, Jack and Tom. I hope you've been lapping up Lapland.
Yes, we have had a great...
It was brilliant.
OK, lads, if you want to be sitting in the driving seat, you'll have to answer at least two of the three following questions correctly. If you don't, Mum and Dad will win.
Well, they're not going to get it.
OK, here goes. Question number one. How did Mum describe husky sledding? Was it A, amazing, or B, breathtaking?
I'm halfway in between amazing and breathtaking. Because Mum really loved that.
Not breathtaking, because Mum doesn't use breathtaking enough or laugh, does she?
No.
She uses amazing a lot.
A, amazing.
Right, let's find out what Mum said.
Oh, come on, please make it right.
Amazing.
Yes.
Well done, lads.
Yes.
One more question
brilliant.
In the driving seat.
That's really brilliant, yes. One more.
Which one of these two activities did Dad say preferred? Was it A, eating round the campfire, or B, feeding the polar bear?
Campfire, because Dad really liked it with the sausages and riding up there on the snowmobiles.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yes.
Plus, we have agreed to go for A,
campfire.
Are you sure? Is that your final answer?
Yes, Kirsten. Yes.
This is what Dad said.
Eating round the campfire.
Yes!
Well done, lads!
Yes!
Yes!
Loser!
Loser!
Kiss the L! The loser!
Winning the treat was like the icing on the cake.
The go-karting was really amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Oh, I'm alive!
Oh! Come on, Tom! Come on, Tom! They deserve to have a treat for getting us on Gimme a Break.
Mum and Dad are really good sports and game for a laugh.
I think the boys have changed me.
I'll cherish it forever, I really will.
I'll remember this for the rest of my life.